सो विथ दैट बैकग्राउंड स्मिथ वन ऑफ द साइंटिस्ट हु स्टडीड क्लीवेज फ्रैक्चर वी आर नाउ डिस्कसिंग स्मिथ मॉडल अगेन विदाउट गोइंग थ्रू ऑल द मैथमेटिकल फॉर्मुलेशन. स्ट्रेस कंसेंट्रेशन ड्यू टू डिसलोकेशन पाइल अप एट अ ग्रेन बाउंड्री कार्बाइड. सो वी हैव टॉक्ट ऑफ ऑल ऑफ दिस अर्लियर राइट दैट वेन अ मटीरियल इज डिफॉर्म्ड डिसलोकेशंस ट्रैवल बट वेन दे रीच अ ग्रेन बाउंड्री दे स्टॉप एंड डिफरेंट डिसलोकेशंस कीप ऑन कमिंग एंड स्टॉपिंग एट द ग्रेन बाउंड्री. सो देर इज अ डिसलोकेशन पाइल अप एट अ ग्रेन बाउंड्री एंड एट दैट ग्रेन बाउंड्री देर वॉज अ कार्बाइड इंक्लूजन राइट. सो बिकॉज ऑफ ऑल ऑफ दिस कॉम्बिनेशन दैट डिसलोकेशंस आर पाइलिंग अप एट द ग्रेन बाउंड्री एंड एट द ग्रेन बाउंड्री देर इज ऑलरेडी अ कार्बाइड इंक्लूजन. सो देर इज अ बिग स्ट्रेस कंसेंट्रेशन. द फेलियर क्राइटीरियन इज दैट सी नॉट सिग्मा एफ स्क्वायर्ड प्लस के वाई स्क्वायर्ड इन टू हाफ प्लस टू टाओ आई रूट ऑफ सी नॉट अपॉन पाई के वाई होल स्क्वायर. दिस होल क्वान्टिटी इज इक्वल टू फोर ई गैमा पी अपॉन पाई इन टू वन माइनस न्यू स्क्वायर. दिस टाइप ऑफ थिंग यू नो फ्रॉम अर्लियर. सो इफ वेन दिस होल क्वान्टिटी बिकम्स इक्वल टू दिस देन देर इज अ फेलियर क्राइटीरियन राइट. रिमेंबर दैट यू सी इट इज नॉट ओनली दैट द क्लीवेज हैज टू इनिशिएट द क्लीवेज हैज टू देन आई मीन प्रोपगेट एंड देन वेन विल इट सडनली आई मीन बिकम अ फेलियर टाइप ऑफ थिंग. सो यू हैव टू हैव अ फेलियर क्राइटीरियन. सो दिस इज द फेलियर क्राइटीरियन इन दिस पर्टिकुलर केस. ऑन द नेक्स्ट पेज इन द फिगर वी विल शो सम SEM फ्रैक्टोग्राफ्स. इन ए क्लीवेज इनिशिएशन इज फ्रॉम अ ग्रेन बाउंड्री कार्बाइड. देर इज अ कार्बाइड पार्टिकल ऑन द ग्रेन बाउंड्री विच कॉजेज द इनिशिएशन ऑफ क्लीवेज. इन बी क्लीवेज इनिशिएशन इज फ्रॉम एन इंक्लूजन एट द इंटीरियर ऑफ अ ग्रेन. सो दिस टाइम द इंक्लूजन पार्टिकल इज इन साइड द ग्रेन. इन बोथ केसेस फ्रैक्चर ऑरिजिन इज लोकेटेड बाई फॉलोइंग द रिवर पैटर्न्स ऑन द फ्रैक्चर सर्फिस राइट. सो इफ वी आर इन दिस फील्ड एंड इफ वी आर स्टडींग क्लीवेज इनिशिएशन एंड अदर टॉपिक्स थ्रू द फ्रैक्टोग्राफ्स देन द टेक्निक इज दैट यू हैव SEM फ्रैक्टोग्राफ्स. रिवर पैटर्न्स आर बींग शोन. एनलार्ज इट मोर. गो टू से फ्रॉम अ 1000 मैग्निफिकेशन टू अ 1500 मैग्निफिकेशन एंड वेन यू सी द पॉइंट एट विच ऑल द रिवर पैटर्न्स कन्वर्ज देन दैट इज द पॉइंट वेयर द क्लीवेज इनिशिएटेड एंड सो ऑन राइट. सो दिस इज अ मेजर बिग टेक्निक. ससेप्टिबिलिटी टू क्लीवेज फ्रैक्चर राइट. द एबिलिटी टू बी फ्रैक्चर्ड बाई क्लीवेज इज एनहांस्ड बाई ऑलमोस्ट एनी फैक्टर दैट इंक्रीजेज द यील्ड स्ट्रेंथ. Try to understand. Increases the yield strength means the material is stronger. Right? If a material, we do some heat treatment or some strain hardening and we increase the yield strength of the material is stronger than before. But remember, strength and hardness go hand in hand. If strength is increased, hardness is also increased. Right? So when a material's yield strength is increased, then its hardness is also increased. It is a harder material than before. And remember that by any method, if you increase the strength of the material, then the ductility also goes down, right? So increase of hardness or increase of strength goes hand in hand with decrease of ductility. So the material has become more brittle in nature. So therefore, it is of course, I mean, you see, on the basis of your basic understanding of material science, if you make a material stronger, its yield strength is higher than before, it is harder and more brittle. So now you would expect that rather than having a ductile failure, it will fail in a brittle manner, right? So that is what they are saying, which is logical scientifically, that the ability or the chances of cleavage fracture are enhanced by almost any factor that increases the yield strength. And any factor that increases the yield strength, low temperature, or triaxial stress state, or radiation damage, or high strain rate, or strain aging, all of these are causes that can increase the yield strength of the material and increase the chances of cleavage fracture. So this is the figure, figure 522, SEM fractographs of cleavage initiation in A508 class 3 alloy. You see, we are giving all the figures, these fractographs and so on, of the same ferritic material, right? So initiation at a grain boundary carbide and initiation at an inclusion near the center of a grain. So here you see here that initiate, and here you are finding, right? So if this is one grain and this is the other grain, then this is the grain boundary and here is the particle. And how do we locate this particle? We enlarge this. This is 50 microns. Now this is only 10 microns. So this is a much enlarged picture, right? And you see all these river patterns are converging at this point. So if you enlarge it further, then you will see, oh, there is an inclusion, a second phase particle, something on the grain boundary. And this caused the initiation. In the second one, if you see that we are trying to find this particle, but when you enlarge it, this particle is not on a grain boundary. This is somewhere inside the grain. This is the whole grain. This is somewhere inside the grain. So you see, when we do these type of studies, we are already sort of an expert in this area. We have studied many fractographs. We have studied ductile fractures and we have studied brittle fractures. And this cleavage fracture is a type of brittle fracture. So we study different areas. Even though they are enlarged already, we further enlarge them and further enlarge them. Once a picture is there saved inside the computer of the scanning electron microscope, then you can enlarge it in any one place, in any two places, in any 100 places, and so on, right? So we are not champions right now, but people who are good will not find this a very difficult task to do if they have done a good fractographic study. Fractographic study, of course, means that they had prepared a sample and they had broken it under tensile loads or impact loads and so on. And then they are studying the fracture surfaces under something like a scanning electron microscope or so on. Let us continue. Grain size refinement. Remember, right? We told you of the methods by which we can increase the strength of a material. So if you have a small grain size, by Hall and Petch equation, the strength is higher. So grain size refinement not only increases the yield strength, but also increases the fracture stress. Right? The stress strain diagram is there. When you do grain size refinement, same material is there, same material. But when you have the metal in a liquid form and then you cool it to room temperature to make ingots or whatever of this material, then you are controlling the cooling rate. And by controlling the cooling rate and so on, you have the same metal, but you have finer grains. So if now you have finer grains, both the yield strength and the fracture strength of the material are higher, right? Number of reasons for the grain size effect are there. In mild steels, the most common structural steel, decrease in grain size implies an increase in grain boundary area. This leads to a smaller grain boundary carbides and an increase in the fracture stress. This is one thing. In fine-grained steels, not mild steels, critical event may be propagation of a micro crack across the first grain boundary it encounters. It breaks the grain boundary, goes into the other, and so on. In such cases, Griffith model gives the following expression for fracture stress. Fracture stress is pi e gamma, but surface energy, right? But gamma gb, something new, upon 1 minus nu squared d. Remember, here it was C naught, the particle, so here also it is D. Gamma GB, grain boundary, is plastic work per unit area required to propagate into the adjoining grains. That you are on the grain boundary, but you want to break from one grain into the other grain. So how much surface energy do you need to provide so that the crack goes from one grain into the other grain? So this is gamma GB. This is gamma GB, right? And D is still the diameter of the particle which was there. So this is one of the theories. And I am showing you it again, right? That if it is on the grain boundary, enlarged version here on the grain boundary, then this was the thing that you see, we are trying to break from one grain into the other grain. If here we have an inclusion particle whose diameter is D, then the amount of surface energy that we would require for the fracture to break from one grain into the other grain at this location is gamma GB, right? So that was the theory. Now we will go into another short topic of ductile to brittle transition. Remember, we are trying to explain ductile failure, and then in the previous section, cleavage failure, based on our basic learning of material science. We reminded you of the Hall-Pech equation, that if you have fine grain size, then the yield strength will be high. And we explained it to you earlier that fine grain size means there are many, many grains, and that means the number of grain boundaries has increased, and each grain boundary is a resistance to the flow of dislocations. So each grain boundary causes dislocation pileup, and because of that, the strength increases and so on, right? So we were trying to have different understandings and so on. And then we showed you some fractographs, right? And that river patterns converge at the particle where the cleavage initiation happened and so on. And now a little bit of ductile to brittle transition. We told you that in certain materials, if you decrease the temperature, then the material is initially ductile, but it will change into a brittle material. We started the whole course with the example of sinking of Titanic and the ductile to brittle transition and so on. So now we will cover a little bit of ductile to brittle transition, and then we will move on to the third type of failure, right? Which is not cleavage failure, right? There is ductile, there is cleavage, which is transgranular, and finally there is intergranular, right? So that will be the next thing. We will today try to stop here, and I would request you to again go through the previous slides and try to really understand the mechanics or the physics of the problem. Very few equations are there, we are not deriving them. And then we will continue with the explanation of ductile to brittle transition, which you already know, but from a materials viewpoint now. So very quickly this, and then we move on to the last mechanism, the intergranular, and follow up like that. So for today, this is where we stop. Thanks a lot. Ma'a salama.